Good evening, everyone. This is Tenken Kaneko and the Daily Ramble. Please remember to subscribe, share, thumbs up, and comment, all that fun stuff. And hey, how you doing? I'm back as usual, and I have decided today to do the video with the very, very minor editing. That is recording first and then uploading. So there's that. It's not for any particular reason. I just thought I should try and keep doing this at least from time to time and make things a little bit more interesting than just that background. Eventually I'll get around to, you know, upping my game again as time goes on, but we'll see how long that takes and depends on how much energy I've got. So recently, as I've mentioned a few times, it's been really, really hot. So today was no exception. I came home and had a shower, but it's actually cooled off. As of right now, it is a nice and cool, waiting for this to reset, 26 degrees and 85% humidity. So what I've actually, when I give you the temperature, what I'm giving you is the heat index. So in this case, it's 23 degrees. That is the air temperature, but with heat index is basically what your body experiences for heat. Now, obviously, some of us are a little different. It's not quite right. It's also known as real feel. But to give you an idea is that the higher the humidity with the heat, the higher the heat index. And that's what we're experiencing for the heat. So we can say, oh, it's only 20 degrees out. But if it's 20 degrees and 100% humidity, it's actually a lot hotter, right? So yesterday, I was teaching a class. I think it was yesterday. Yes, it was yesterday, and I don't know if I mentioned it, but one of the girls literally fell out of her seat and crawled into the hallway because she was hyperventilating from heat exhaustion, and it was 30 degrees in the class. That's the air temperature was 30 degrees. It was actually, with the humidity, it was 36 degrees inside the school. I let that sink in for a bit. In the classrooms, not outside, not in the shade somewhere else, but inside of the classrooms, it was 36 degrees. It was really, really hot. Considering that our body temperature is between 35 and 37 degrees, that really sucked. And this was with two fans going, all the windows open, but there was just no wind. It really was not a good day yesterday. Today wasn't as bad. It wasn't too bad, but it was still 33 degrees most of the day, 30 before the temperature, 29. And like this morning was 28 degrees when I opened my eyes, and that's air temperature, 28 degrees. So it was like 31 degrees. It's just madness. Anyway, it's cooling off. It looks like the next few days is going to be fairly cool, which is going to be a good change. So, I take a lot of pictures, as I've mentioned before, and one of the things that I really like taking pictures of, other than, well, there's a few things. So I love taking pictures of scenery, trees and flowers, especially, and weather systems. Just, I like those things. And one of the other ones is temples and small things like shrines, like hidden away things, things that are not something that people always look at. So in this case, here, that's like a little lantern that sits out in the middle of the pond. They don't light it. This is just like one of the stone lanterns. There are spirit lights, if I have my mythology correct. You know, it's a place for spirits to go and hide and light up at night. You know, so I think there's some mythology around them, but I just thought this one was really cool because it's a very Japanese and sort of a very Occidental thing to have lanterns in ponds and things. You'll see this in China and Korea and Japan. Now, I say this only from looking at media online and through television and mass media from what I've seen in China and Korea. I've never been there myself yet, but I will. However, it is all over Japan. There are these lanterns and things like that sitting in ponds and even whole temples. Like there's Kinkakuji. No, that's not right. That is totally wrong. Anyway, there's I totally forgot the name. I had the name in my head, but it's just gone. It's the heat, I swear. There's two temples. Kinkakuji? Never mind, I'm not going to try anymore. That's embarrassing. One is the gold temple and one is the silver temple. And the most famous one that most people know about is the gold temple that sits in a pond in Kyoto. And it basically that is actually burned down a couple of times. And one of the times I think it was just a monk had gone crazy and burned it down. And it's been rebuilt and reestablished a few times. And you can see pictures of it when it's in the snow or autumn. So it has like all four seasons and they're crazy different. You know, like when we think of four seasons classically in our head, you know, you have autumn with bright, vibrant colors in the leaves and there are oranges and yellows and browns and reds and yellows. I don't know if I said that twice. And then in winter, it's like piles of snow and white and black, right? And then in spring, it's sprouts of green and tons of colorful flowers. And then in summertime, it's a solid green, but it's heat soaked and it's not as colorful as spring. And those temples in that area, like Kiyomizu-dera, for example, Dera, is the water temple, Kyoto. And it's the same thing. Like it's just at some points it's covered in snow and some points it's just lit up with colorful leaves in autumn and things like that. So I love taking pictures of those things. So I thought I'd share one of my photographs of just some weird little thing in a pond, really. And yeah, I don't know. I kind of want to drink the water. I'm going to have water after I'm done this video because I'm thirsty. Anyways, I'll catch you later. That's the Daily Ramble. Have a good one. I will see you tomorrow. Cheers.